Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about the bubble sort. Yes, bubble sort is also one of the sorting techniques to sort the elements either ascending order or in the descending order, right? So in bubble sort, each element of the array is compared with its adjacent elements. This algorithm processes the list and passes. That means in this bubble sort, the procedure is each element of the array is compared with its adjacent element, that is side element, and the two elements are compared with each other. If it is sorted in the sorted form, then the two elements will be swapped with each other, right? This algorithm processes the list in passes, that means number of cycles. A list with n elements the requires n minus 1 passes for sorting. In case of bubble sort, if the list is having n elements, right, to sort all the elements of the list, we need n minus 1 passes. That means n minus 1 iterations that are required to sort all the elements in the particular list, right? That is called bubble sort. Consider an array A of n elements whose elements are to be sorted by using the bubble sort. Let us explain this bubble sort procedure. In pass 1, A of 0, that means the value that is located at A of 0th location is compared with the value located at A of 1. Right? That means the first two elements are compared with each other. A of 1 is compared with A of 2. Next, the element at A of 1 is compared with A of 2. After that, the element at A of 2 is compared with A of 3, and so on till the end of the list. At the end of pass 1, that is the first cycle, that is first iteration, the largest elements of the list is placed at the highest index of the list. Okay, whatever the largest elements of the list are placed at the highest index of the list, that is at the end of the list. In pass 2, again the same procedure is repeated. A of 0 is compared with A of 1, A of 1 is compared with A of 2, and A of 2 is compared with A of 3, and so on. At the end of pass 2, the second largest element is stored at the second highest index of the list. And similarly, already we discussed, if there are n elements in the list, n minus 1 passes are required. So in the pass n minus 1, again the same procedure, A of 0 is compared with A of 1, and A of 1 is compared with A of 2, and so on, right? This is the procedure what we follow in case of bubble sort. Let us explain this bubble sort with an example, right? In pass 1, starting from the first index, compare the first and the second elements. Right, first index means at A of 0. Right, the first two elements, that is the first element is at A of 0 and the second element is at A of 1. If the first element is greater than second element, what do? We have to swap each other. Right, now compare the second and third elements. Again, the second element is greater than the third element, swap them if they are not in the order. This process goes on continuous until the last element of the list, right? See, this is the given list of elements. This array contains how many elements? 5 elements, right? This elements, the array contains both positive and negative elements, no problem. The first element is minus 2 and then 45 and then 0, 11 and minus 9. These are the 5 elements in the given list. What do? The first element is compared with second element. Minus 2 is compared with 45. That means minus 2 is less than 45. So no need to swap the elements. Minus 2 is the smallest, which lies in the first location only. 45 is the highest, that lies after minus 2. So no need to swap the elements. So come to the next step. Then compared second and third elements. Here the 45 is compared with 0. So 45 is greater than 0. They are not in the ascending order. So what do? We have to swap these two elements. 0 comes at this location and 45 comes at this location. Reverse. So 0 and 45. Now compare third and fourth elements. 45 and 11. Again the 45 is greater than 11. So we have to swap these two elements. Then 11 comes to this position and 45 comes to the next position. Right. Now compare 4 and 5 elements. 45 and minus 9. So 45 is greater than minus 9. That's why again swap these two elements. So minus 9 comes to this position and 45, the highest element that is located at the last index, that is at the last position. So 45, you see. So at the end of pass 1, that is completion of first cycle. So this is the list which contains the elements minus 2, 0, 11, minus 9, 45. Check all these elements are in the ascending order. No. What do we do? Again, consider this array and start the second pass, second iteration. Right. So minus 2, 0, 11, minus 9 and 45. With this array, we will start the second iteration. Again, we can repeat the same procedure. Compare the first two elements, minus 2 and 0. Which one is smaller? Minus value is smaller. So no need to swap these elements. Then compare second and third elements, 0 and 11. 0 is less than 11 only. So no need to swap these two elements. And next, compare third and fourth elements, 11 and minus 9. 11 is greater than minus 9. So we have to swap these two elements. That is, minus 9 comes to this position and 11 comes to the next position. Right. So minus 9 and 11. Next, compare 11 and 45. Okay. 11 is less than 45. So no need to swap these two elements. Right. This is the end of the list. So after the completion of pass 2, check the elements whether they are in the sorted list or not. Minus 2, 0, minus 9, 11 and 45. Whether these are in the sorted form? No. Minus 9 is less than 0. So we need to swap these two. So go for the next pass, that is the next iteration with this elements of the list. Yes, minus 2, 0, minus 9, 11, 45. Again, do the same procedure. Compare the first two elements, minus 2 and 0. Which one is smaller? Minus 2 is smaller. So they are in the sorted form. No need to swap the elements. So compare next two elements, 2 and 3, 0 and minus 9. So 0 is greater than minus 9. So that we have to swap these two elements. So minus 9 comes to this position and 0 goes to next position. So minus 2, minus 9, 0. And compare the next two elements, 0 and 11. So they are in the sorted form. No need to swap again. And compare 4 and 5, 11 and 45. They are in the sorted form. No need to swap the elements. So at the end of pass 3, okay, these are the elements, minus 2, minus 9, 0, 11 and 45. They are in the sorted form. So the list is sorted. So this is how we can sort the elements by using the bubble sort. Okay, this is about the bubble sort. Just we'll stop the session here. We'll discuss the next technique in the next class. Thank you.